Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 0 of Vagrant Giants Co-op with Udeldor.
Hey, Koryanje!
Hello! So, today we will be starting our new multiplayer Let's Play on the Vagrant Giants modpack, which is, as the name would suggest, created by a friend of ours named Vagrant, which is pretty cool. And we're pretty excited about that. We are quite sad that our previous series that we did a co-op on, which was Utopia, ended so early. So we decided to start a new co-op Let's Play with just the two of us and not a full server. So pretty much we have full control of everything. And yeah, we'll just hope to have a fun Let's Play, have a blast, do cool stuff, explode stuff, and just do cool stuff. All the things and stuff.
Yeah, loads of mods to mess around with.
Yes, exactly. So, for those that don't know this modpack, Vagrant Giants is a modpack created by, like I already said, Vagrant, on Minecraft 1.7.10. I believe it was created fully by his mind of balancing, so pretty much what he thinks works best in a modpack is all, of course, created in this. And yep. In my opinion, and I think also in Udeldor's, this is quite a nice combination of mods. For example, if I can show you guys in Not Enough Items, we got mods like Blood Magic to add a little bit touch of magic. Bibliocraft, for example, to get a little touch of aesthetic purposes. We got Buildcraft for a tech mod. Ender.io, extra utilities. Chisel, also a very nice aesthetic mod that we are currently running at. Let's quickly scroll through this, a lot of pages. Forge Microblocks. Forge Microblocks is also, of course, a mod that is unmissable in any modern-day mod pack that runs Forge. We got Jabba, which is always an amazing mod to store stuff in. Mechanism, one of the famous tech mods out there. We got Open Blocks, which is one of my favorite random items mods. Then we got Project Red, which is something I'm really excited about, since the last few Let's Plays that I did didn't have this mod. So we can do some very awesome cool redstone trickery, and I believe this even adds a few other cool additions like sorting, so that's pretty cool. We got Project E, which, well...
Oh yes.
This is just the mod that I'm one of the most excited things about, because for those that don't know it, there used to be a mod called Equivalent Exchange 2, which came out, I believe, end of beta, or Equivalent Exchange 1 came out end of beta, and Equivalent Exchange 2 came out early release, I believe, of Minecraft itself. And pretty much it is about blocks that you have a specific value called an EMC value, which I think stands for Energy Matter Conversion or something like that.
Currency.
Ah, right. Yes.
Yes.
And pretty much this allows you to transmute items into other items that have the same value, or combine a lot of items with low values to turn them into high values and the other way around. And this also adds a bunch of other cool rings and armor and bands and tools and EMC generation stuff. And this is just gonna be so awesome.
Yeah, just to indicate how overpowered the mod is, it adds an item called a repair talisman that will repair all your tools for free at a pretty quick speed as well. That's how OP the mod is.
Yes. And don't forget, we also got ourselves a catalytic lens, which allows one to pretty much dig out an area. I believe it's 3x3x64, just with a click of a button, and all these items will be teleported to you. So that's just a quick example of something that this mod can do. So I'm really excited that this mod got ported to 1.7.10.
Very cool.
Yes. Then we also got Random Things, which is also a very nice random items mod. We got Refined Relocation, Flexbeard's Steam Power, which I have not yet messed around with, but I'm sure we will be doing that. We got Steve's Cards, an old favorite of mine that allows you to make cards, of course. We got Storage Drawers, which is also very nice. A little addition that allows you to store things. I guess I can compare it a little bit to Jabba, but then a little bit different.
It's kind of like a mix of Bibliocraft and Jabba, I'd say.
Yes, pretty cool. Then we got my all-time favorite magic mod, which is, of course, as you could know from my previous Let's Play, Tomcraft. And with Tomcraft, we got ourselves the add-on Tomic Tinkerer, which is awesome. We got the Tubes mod, which is always nice. The Twilight Forest, yay for dimensions.
Yay!
Yoo-hoo! Then we got a bunch of pages with chisel stuff. We got the crafting pillars mod, which is just awesome for showcasing all the cool things. Dimensional storage, which is something I believe Vagrom also spotlighted, so that's pretty awesome mod. Pretty much a sort of ender chest type of mod. We got Erebus, which I am not sure what that mod is, but I am sure we will find some cool uses for it. As you can see, it adds a bunch of items that I have no idea what to do yet.
I believe that's also a new dimension mod, so that's pretty cool.
Yes, like things like Bio Velocity and Supernatural Velocity and Repellent and all that cool stuff.
I have no idea what it adds.
Me neither, but it's going to be cool.
Yeah.
Of course. How can we play a mod pack without having a bunch of different seeds and plants and foods? We got Bam's Harvestcraft. So cool. Over 8 pages... No, that's over-exaggerated. 5 pages full of food and seeds and all different kinds of dishes we can make, so that's going to be cool. And then, last but not least, or almost last, we got DecoCraft, which is courtesy of the amazing Raz. Awesome, cool models, around 3 pages worth of those on my screen. We got Richery, also a very nice magic mod. And I think that's pretty much it for the mod list. Did I miss anything really important?
I do not think you missed anything important, no. Awesome. And of course, you know, we have these really small mods as well, like just looking through here, we've got mods like Ender Utilities, but those mainly add like convenience items. But just the mods Koryonshi just spoke about, that's, well, quite a lot to do.
Yes. So, I hope you guys are just as excited as we are, because, well, we have been talking about doing something together for quite a while, and now we finally had the opportunity to do so, so that's pretty cool. And we also did quite a lot of measures to make this series as smooth as possible. One of the mods that we got installed is FastCraft to increase our frame rate. As you can currently see, I'm around 140 frames per second while recording and hosting the server on my own PC, so that will make this series very, very smooth. I also generated using the admin's toolbox or command box or something like that. It's from Professor Mobius, I believe. So yeah, you should know that mod if you're a server admin. I generated an area from -16,000 to 16,000 in each direction. So that's over 4 million chunks. Yeah. So I don't expect we would need to ever explore that far away. So we probably won't be having any generation lag. And for those who have not figured it out yet, yes, we are currently playing on the amplified biome mode. Yeah. That's why we got these amazing freaking biomes like mountains and rivers and yeah, I just can't imagine making beautiful mountain houses and things coming from the side of this. And just gonna be amazing.
And this is a forest biome.
Yes, just imagine us living in a extreme hills biome, just freaking from bedrock to the world height houses or mountains. Yeah. So yeah, we're gonna have a blast. So anything else I should add to that, or?
I don't think so. All the information about the pack, you can find links to that in the descriptions, as well as links to each other's channels. So it's gonna be cool. You can find all the information there if you're interested. The casual fun mod pack. I'd say it's something for everyone. Everyone can play this pack. And we are going to have loads of fun.
Yes, we will. So I guess we mean we'll be signing off here. So thanks for watching. Like Yudalo said, all the links will be in the description below, so you can check that out. Probably you can also follow us on our social media. Subscribe to both of our channels to stay up to date with both of our perspectives. And yeah, it's going to be cool stuff. So I hope to see you guys all next time.
Yeah, thank you guys for watching. And hope you guys enjoyed the videos. Like them. And we will see you guys next time. Take care.
Bye-bye.